Dear brothers and sisters, I wish all Indians a happy Republic Day. On January 26, 2021, we are celebrating 72nd Republic Day. And it's the time for us to take stock of the situation. I would like to share a few thoughts about India and the things we have accomplished and the things which are yet to be accomplished. The year 2020 has thrown the world out of gear because of coronavirus, and we are gradually coming out of the challenge. We got vaccine and things are moving in a right direction, and we show to the world that we Indians can overcome any kind of adversity, and we have displayed in case of this pandemic. And we have a challenge across the border. I hope we'll be able to come out of that challenge very soon. We started National Education Policy 2020, which is a step in the right direction. Previously, we followed rote learning, cramming. Now, this NEP 2020 emphasizes on creativity, critical thinking. It promotes scientific temper in students in the very early age, and it enhances skills, it enhances employability, because it emphasizes practical education. And there is growing urbanization across the world and in India. So there is a need for building enough homes. So all the thought leaders, government bodies, intellectuals, non-profits must work together to address the challenges. We also have the challenge of unemployment and poverty. So likewise, and it's a great pride that we Indians are doing good across the world. The Indians who adapted to their countries are doing good. They are bringing learnings to our country. It's a matter of pride for us. And we have Indians CEOs for top companies like Microsoft and Google. So these are all the great signs that India is doing good. I would like to share a couple of messages on the eve of Republic Day. First one is, love your mother but don't hate another person's mother. That means love your country but don't hate another person's country. Love your language, love your religion, love your caste, love your community, but don't hate another person's language, culture, caste and community. Because as your mother is precious to you, another person's mother is equally precious to him or her. So let us empathize with others, let us be kind, let us be compassionate. We Indians believe in Vasudeva Kutumbakam, that means entire world is one family. So we should follow the spirit of empathy, compassion. Secondly, we should emphasize on woman empowerment. A bird cannot fly with one wing, it needs two wings to fly. So a society cannot grow with one gender, so society needs both genders. So both women and men must collaborate and work together to build a better global society. So I advocate gender equality globally. So these are all the things we need to take care of. And also, India is blessed with human resources and natural resources. We must know how to leverage them effectively. I implore all Indians to have a right attitude, positive attitude and strong attitude. And also to be punctual and to stay committed to build a strong India. I implore all Indians to work smart, work hard, work wise to build a strong India. And Barack Obama has written a book, A Promised Land, in which he talked about the greatness of India. He was influenced by Mahatma Gandhi. Several leaders have been influenced by Mahatma Gandhi. Several Nobel laureates have been influenced by Mahatma Gandhi across the world. So these are all the signs of our greatness, and we must work hard to build a better and strong India. God bless India, God bless world. Jai Hind.